Hi, I'm Keith with Danfoss Food Retail Controls, and today's video will be on the wiring for both power and communications to the 525A case control.
Thanks, Keith. Today we're going to look at this case controller, which controls superheat, temperature, lights, fans, defrost, and anti-sweats for a single evaporator. One thing to note about this case controller is that there is no built-in display and buttons to allow interrogation, so we've hooked up an external display and button configuration here so we can do that. The Danfoss AK-CC 525A is similar to the AK-CC 550A, but there are a few key differences. For one, you'll notice that we have an external display that's optional instead of a built-in display. Any buttons that we would use are also incorporated into the external display, and this is a cost reduction controller, you might say, because there are some things here that are optional. Obviously, the display is one of them. Also, there are some features internally that have been removed for those who want a more cost-effective controller. Some things like adaptive defrost and the dual temp feature has been removed from this controller. Across the top here, we have, similar to other controllers like the 550A, we do have a DI1 and a DI2. These can be used for things like digital inputs, for dual temp switches, case clean switches, door switches, and similar options. Then moving on down, we have the pressure transducer. For this AK-CC 525A, that would be the AKS32R pressure transducer. Moving down the line, we have the S2 coil outlet sensor, the optional S3 return air sensor, and the S4 discharge air sensor. And rounding out the sensors, we would have the optional S5 defrost termination sensor. Our next connection is the connection for the remote display. And then we have two connections here for one of two communication options. Communication options we have are the built-in Modbus RS-485, and the electronics is already built in here. If you want to use the LAN RS-485 option, then we have to install a communication card in the front of the controller. We'll show how to install that card now. First of all, we want to remove power from the controller. Next, we'll remove plastic cover from the front of the controller. We'll install the card right side up. There's grooves inside this rectangle that guide you. You want to make sure the card is installed all the way in. Then we'll put the plastic cover back in place. Next step, we'll power up the controller. And now we could address the controller using the parameters built in to set the address for this one. Across the bottom, we have relay connections for the AKV solenoid valve that pulses liquid into the coil. Then we have connections for the evaporator fans, the defrost relay, and the anti-sweat relay. These relays are not fused internally, so any fusing would be done external to this controller. The internal relays in this controller do have current limits, so they have to be observed, and any pilot relays that would be wired between this controller and the load would have to be sized accordingly to inrush current and running load amps and things like that. If we look at the remote display, we can interrogate the parameters. So as you can see, we have three buttons on the display, and they all have different functions. The middle button can be used to set your cutout temperature at any time for the case that we are controlling. We can see this one is set to 35.4. If we want to lower it to 35, we use the bottom button for that, and then we just save it by pressing the set button. If we want to raise it, we can go up with the top button to 35.5, and then we can save it with the set button. The top button will give us status indications. Like for instance, right now we're getting a status code of S23. We could look that up in our manual or on the Cool Code app to find out what that's telling us. And if we hold it again, we can get alarm indications if there are any. This controller has no alarms currently. So we'll hold it a little longer and that'll take us into the parameter settings. Right now we can get into the config menu. We can go into the inlet settings, outlet settings, or the R parameters in this case. If we press the set button, it'll give us indications of which R parameters we want to view. Like for instance, the R01 parameter is the differential setting. If we want to see what it's set to, we can see it's set to 3.6. Let's lower that down to 2.0, and then we'll save it with the middle button. If we want to go to another parameter, we could scroll down through the list with the lower button, or we could go back up through the list with the top button. If we do nothing, for approximately 15 seconds, it'll time out and go back to the temperature display. If this case controller has a defrost termination sensor connected to it, we can see that reading at any time by doing a short press on the bottom button. If there is no S5 termination sensor assigned or wired, then we'll just see NON on the display. And that's the AK-CC 525A single evaporator case controller.
For more information on this topic, see the description below. And for more videos like this, visit our YouTube channel, Danfoss Cool US, and thank you for watching.